Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another tutorial. And in today's Shopify tutorial video, I'm going to teach you guys how you can add clickable banner image. So by default in Shopify 2.0 themes, for example, Dawn, Fresh, Sten's theme, they don't have a clickable banner image section. So when you add a image banner section, you can add a button, but you won't be able to add a link to the whole banner image. So as you can see that on my screen, I have Dawn latest version 12.0.0 and my banner image is clickable. So no matter wherever I take my mouse, it's clickable and I can simply click on the banner and it will take me to the product page. And I can also change the product page link through my customize. So that's the customize settings. And as you can see, I have this banner link option. So if I change it to any other product, so let's suppose change it to this product here, example t-shirt. And now if I hit save and go back to my store, hit refresh. Sorry, I need to preview this theme here. Now if I click on the banner here, you can see it's taking me to the product which I selected on my customize settings here. So that's where I selected to which product I want to link this banner to, and it's taking me to that banner, right? By default, there is no option to add a link. So that's the default Dawn theme customize settings, and that's the image banner section. Now, if I go to image banner, you can see that we don't have any option to add a link to the complete banner. You can add a button. You can add a button to link that to that specific product, but you cannot add a link to the whole banner. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can do that really easily. All you have to do is just copy and paste the code and follow this video completely to make this happen. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, comment to the video below. That's all we are asking from you guys in order to make us more valuable content for you. And in future, with this channel, we are planning to add in more content. So for example, Figma tutorials, video editing tutorials, and a lot more stuff is coming to this channel. So if you want to notify it, subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon. Okay, now let's start implementing the tutorial. And I'm going to close all the tabs and just go to the Shopify backend first and add in the fresh Dawn theme in order to show you guys where you need to add the code, which I'm going to tell you guys. Okay, that's the backend of the Shopify store. Click on online store, and that's the Dawn theme where I already added the clickable image banner code. Now I'm going to add a fresh Dawn theme. So if I scroll down, I have this sections showing up where we have option to add all of the themes: Dawn, Spotlight, Refresh, Cart, Sense. You can implement this code on any of the 2.0 theme. You can also try that on the paid theme, but you need to know where the code has to be added. So this tutorial is specifically for all of the 2.0 themes. If you are using any paid theme, you will need more consultation on that. Okay, now I'm going to add a fresh Dawn theme. Okay guys, so fresh Dawn theme has been installed. I'm going to publish that one now. So click on publish and then publish button again. And here we go. Our fresh Dawn theme has been published. Now let's preview it. And now you can see that the image banner section is not clickable. And now when I go to customize settings, and here's the image banner section. Now there is no option where we can add the link to whole banner. We can add the button. So here's the button, which we have it showing up here. We can simply add the link to this button, but we cannot link the whole banner image. Okay, now let's add an option to create a link on this banner and make it clickable. Okay, let's go back to the theme section and then click on three small dots and then click on edit code. Guys, before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme. So duplicate your theme, download it, or have a backup of your theme, because if something bad happens, please don't blame me on the comments. I'm getting a lot of comments that my code broke your website. Guys, this is a free tutorial. I'm not asking you for any money. It's just a free help from my side. So I always say to have a duplicate of your theme, and you should have it, because it's not everyone's game to add in the code, or it's not everyone's game to play with the code, right? So, okay, click on edit code, and now we will search for image. Oops, sorry. Image-banner, and here we go. So that's the image-banner.liquid file where we will be editing and adding some code in order to make it clickable. Okay, here's the blog post. The blog post link you will find in the YouTube video description. So in image-banner.liquid file, search for this code. So I'm just going to copy this and search it here. And after the closing of inverted commas, just add an additional space and then add in this code. And now, oops, sorry about that. And now scroll down to schema settings. So here are the schema settings. And we will add a line break after this code. So you can pause this video and see where I'm adding the schema code. And now hit enter. Now copy the schema code from here. Again, you will find the blog post link in the YouTube video description. So all you have to do is just copy and paste the code provided, right? And once the code is pasted, click on save. That's all you had to do in order to make your image banner section clickable. And now let's preview the store. Also open the customize. So click on these three small dots and then click on customize theme. Now, if we go to image banner, you can see we have this banner link option showing up. So click on this field and you can link it to a blog post if you want to. You can link to any page if you want to. In my case, I'll just link it with any of the product. So let's link it with this gray t-shirt product and then hit save. And let's wait for it to save. Click on these three small dots and then click on view. And here we go. Now you can see when I move my mouse over the banner, it's clickable and it should be linked to my gray t-shirt product. And now when I click on it, it takes me to that gray t-shirt product. Cool, right? So that's it, guys. That's it for the tutorial. If you guys liked what I created and if you guys want to see more tutorial like this, please let me know in the comments below what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.